Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning. I'm Swetha Srikanth of Class 9 from the PSBB Millennium School, and I'm here to speak on the topic School Education Today and Tomorrow. The first question that popped into my head when I started preparing for the speech was, what exactly is the meaning of the word education? Looking at its etymology, the word education is derived from the Latin word educatus, which means to rise, to nourish, or to draw out. So basically, through education, the potential of a person should be given scope for development, and the powers of an individual should be developed with proper care and nourishment. This gave me another question. Does the current education scenario in India satisfy this definition? Without any doubt, school education in India has transformed in leaps and bounds and has definitely evolved for the better. Today, there's a lot of emphasis on concept-based education and hands-on experiments and projects. Technological tools like smart boards and visual media have transformed education in a myriad of ways. School education today is not just about excelling in academics, but also in various other fields like sports and fine arts. So as I said, there has been a lot of change, but there is still scope for improvement. While today there's a lot of stress being laid on concept-based education, I don't think we've still completely come out of the idea of rote learning or reproducing exactly from the textbook. Many surveys have proven that some of the top rank holders in schools are unable to cope up with the college curriculum because of this habit of learning without understanding. The most common words in a student's life are exams, tests, assessments, and all other synonyms of the same. By the end of 12 years of school education, a student is completely burnt out and is devoid of energy, zest, and creativity. Another major drawback of the current education system is that the word intelligence is often equated to proficiency in only certain subjects like mathematics and science. However, going forward, I'd like to see an education system that helps a child realize his potential, be it in sports, writing, filmmaking, or any other field. Similarly, there's a huge craze for professional courses like engineering and medicine, and there's a scarcity in the number of people opting for vocational courses. Practically speaking, a society cannot exist with just engineers and doctors. It needs people with these vocational skills too. And that's why I feel that the system should lay a little more importance on that aspect. Education is supposed to make a person a better human being. But looking at the increase in violence in society, and especially in classrooms, makes one introspect on our existing system. Our education is all about assimilating facts, formulas, and equations, and there's very less emphasis on holistic development. Education is not just about intelligence. It's about intelligence plus character. While everything in life must be well organized, I feel that our education system is a little too structured. There's very little scope for flexibility, and this is why I feel that the concept of personalized education must come to practice. At this moment, I am reminded of a very famous quote. If you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life thinking that it's a fool. Students must be encouraged to strengthen their natural talents and develop their own unique skills. Teachers should act as mentors and provide an environment for learning at one's own pace and in one's own way. For instance, if a student is extremely proficient in a particular subject, he or she should be allowed to take advanced classes in that subject. Acquiring knowledge shouldn't be a nerve-wracking process. It should be a seamless and an effortless one. Only then will students really enjoy schooling. And the success of education can be seen when students stop having Monday morning blues. I envisage an education that breaks the four bounds of a classroom and something that's more in tune with the real world. I also look forward to a system that shifts from being exam-centric to knowledge-centric. Education must kindle a student's thought and curiosity. And this is why I feel that students should be exposed to basic research fundamentals at an early age so that they're in the habit of questioning why and not just accepting things the way they are. Today's education scenario is such that some of the top scorers in top institutes are finding it difficult to get jobs because of lack of communication skills, organizing capacity, leadership qualities, and team spirit. Education is not just about earning a certificate or a degree. It's about acquiring these life skills, and it's about our actions, attitude, and personality. In my opinion, an ideal school education for tomorrow should be something like what Albert Einstein said. Education is what remains even after one has forgotten everything he's learnt in school. Thank you.